nice five separate triangles. Alright, so what is the use for all this is to help us to do calculations like this. And typically this is what is expected of us. Typically they will give you the information about something in the chemical equation, and then they will ask you to find out information of another compound. So whenever you see this kind of questions where they ask you to do calculation, automatically means that you need to use or to apply all these formulas. Alright, so we have to memorize these important steps. It's a three important steps. I call them the Moraka. So the first is mole, then ratio, and then you change. Alright? So if you are not copying, I'll suggest that you try to do something about it, because this will be 50% of your exam next week. Which means that if there are 20 questions, there will be 10 questions on this. This includes MCQ. So which means that next week Joshua need to do 30 MCQ questions.
40.
40. 20 will be on this. So I would appreciate that you all put in extra effort today to try to understand how this works. Yeah, because if not, next week you all have a lot of problems. So don't need to copy this, because this one you already copied before. Just copy these simple questions. Alright? And in O-level, the combined chemistry, you are expected to know how to solve this. And there are a lot of marks to be given. Alright? So questions like this, for example this, there will be a minimum of 3 to 4 marks. So normally there will be 3 marks, for example. I'll tell you what is the allocation of the marks. Yes, that's a very good. Xavier took out the periodic table. We definitely need periodic table so that we can solve this. Okay. Here it says there was this particular element called carbon reacted with oxygen and it gives a carbon dioxide. So for example, like the charcoal, you burn the charcoal, alright? Then some of the charcoal will react with the oxygen in the air and they produce carbon dioxide. Was it okay? So they told us that the mass of the carbon reacted is 6 grams. Okay? So the first step is you are supposed to find the mole. Alright? So the question is, which mole are you need to find? Is it the mole of the carbon, or the mole of the oxygen, or the mole of the carbon dioxide? What do you think? Which mole that I can find? Is it this one that I can find, or I can find this one, or I can find this one? Which one? Yes, Joshua? You want to do something? The clue is from the questions. The clue is from the questions. Which element? C. Correct. So which means that the mole that you're supposed to find is to find the mole of carbon. Alright? So how do you find the mole of the carbon when they give you mass? So this is gram. Yeah, so which triangle that we can use? The triangle that we can use is this triangle. This triangle that you can use. Or, if you prefer the smaller triangle, then it will be this triangle. So we're going to write this. Mole is equals to mass number 1660. Okay, mass divided by molar mass. Alright, so what is the mass? So the mass is here, 6 gram. So you'll be 6 divided by what is the molar mass? This molar mass you can get from periodic table. So you look at your periodic tables, okay, specifically look for carbon, alright, there is two numbers. So there's one number at the bottom which is 6, and there is a bigger number that is 12. So you change back to that. Okay. So what is this number? 12, right? What number is this? What do you call this number?
Atomic mass.
Yeah, atomic mass or mass number. So this is the number that you should put inside here. 12. So this number, you go to here. So 6 divided by 12 is equals to? Which is, put, yeah, please put it in decimal places. Yeah, 0.5 mole. So we done the first step, so first step is done. Okay. So, what is the second step? The second step says that we are supposed to do ratio. Ratio means you divide something with something. You compare something with something. Alright? So what are the something and something? So when ratio, you need two elements or compounds. You need to compare two stuff, two things. So what are the two things that you should compare? Carbon. You need to compare carbon. And what else do you need to compare?
CO2.
Why do we need to compare these two? Why can't I compare C with O2? Or why can't I compare O2 with CO2? Correct. So Ethan says that the information given to us, they were talking about carbon. They were talking about carbon dioxide. So put your focus onto the C and the CO2, not because you like it, not because you love it, not because you fancy of these two, but it was because these are the two dimensions in the question. Was it okay, Joshua?
Just like follow the question.
Correct, follow the question. So the question say, compare C and CO2. Don't argue, follow. Okay, so how do we do ratio? Okay, do we remember that when we first do a balancing equation, we always say that if you see no numbers here, actually what is this number?
One.
What is this number?
One.
What is this number? One. Okay, yeah? So Joshua, for you will be especially important because you haven't learned ratio. So you learn ratio here, then when you max, then you actually will understand it better. Yeah?
How I do is I do above or below the C, O2 and CO2. So I'll write 1 mole, 1 mole, 1 mole. Mm. So if the C is 0.5, and then since that one is 1 mole, then there should be, then there should be CO2 divided by
2. Okay, that's a good method. Okay, so we're going to explore different methods. So for Joshua, as you consider this, Jisha, when you consider this, you choose a method that you are comfortable with. Was it okay? The word ratio means something divided by something. Have you learned this? This one? This line? Like 4 divided by 2? Have you learned this? So of course, it means 4 like that, divided by 2. In fact, these divisions, right, is actually telling you that there is something here divided by something. That's what the symbol is all about. Alright, so you put this, okay? Then you put carbon, okay? Then you put carbon dioxide at the bottom. Is it okay? So, what is the number here, Joshua? What's this number? Okay, so it's 1 over 1. Can you sure? Can you understand? 1 divided by 1.
It's still 1.
Okay, wait. So then, what is the information given to us here? You realize that the carbon is 0.5. Okay, Joshua. So the next step is 0.5 divided by CO2 equals to 1 over 1. 1 over 1 is 1, right? 1 divided by 1 is 1, right? Let's say that you're not very sure, you have calculators, you can just press it. You see 1 divided by 1, is it 1? Then it's 1, then okay, then right now. Was it okay? Then, ask yourself, 1 divided by 1 equals to 1? This is 0.5, right? 0.5 divided by 1 equals to 1?
0.5.
0.5, right? Okay, Joshua. Okay, so therefore, CO2 is equals to 0.5. There is a technique. There is a technique. Yeah, not yet, we haven't reached that step yet. There is a step that in secondary school they call cross multiplication. Cross multiplication means from here the CO2, you bring it across diagonally opposite up. And then the 1, you bring it diagonally opposite up. So which means for this case, 0.5 times 1 equals to 1 times CO2. Therefore, CO2 is equals to 0.5. This is called cross multiplication method. You only learn this, alright? You only learn this when you have divisions in this way. Was it okay? So you cross multiply. Joshua, do you know what's cross multiplication? Okay. I give an example, cross multiplication. Let's say that for example, 1 over x equals to 2 over 3. Okay, Joshua, look up here. Are you sure? Have you learned cross multiplication?
Yeah.
Have you learned?
It's equals to 1
over
5.
Is it like the fractions, two fractions, you want to find the
number
of
integers? Yeah, correct. So, but in secondary school, they specifically say that this method is called cross multiplication. Cross means, you see there's a cross here, right? Can you see? Cross, cross. So cross means that the 3 go over to this side, the x go to this side. So which means 1 times 3 equals to 2 times x, which is 2x.
So 2x equals to 3.
Yeah, so that 4 means 2x is equals to 3, x is equals to 3 divided by 2. It will be a bit harder for you, Joshua. So there are some techniques here involve a little bit of P6 or even Sec 1 work. Yeah, that one is algebra, correct. Okay, so this is one method. But let's just say that you find it confusing. Okay? So I recommend the next method. Or I'm gonna go quite slow because this is quite important. Because the rest of the chemistry, whenever there's a calculation, will always be more concept. For the next 2 years, it will be more concept, calculations. Okay? So, this way, Joshua, Jisha, Chester, are you ready? So, 1 mole of C produce 1 mole of CO2. 0.5 mole of C produces how much mole of CO2? Chester, do you know what's the answer?
0.5,
huh? Okay, because the answer is here. But let me just change this. Okay, Joshua, ready? If for example, 1 mole of carbon produces 2 mole of
one.
Carbon dioxide.
One.
You are Joshua? I'm asking Joshua. 0.5 mole of carbon produces? Why is it 3? Okay, look at this, this relationship. Yeah, because this is involve a bit of secondary maths, that's why I have to slow down a little. So 1 mole of carbon produces 2 moles of CO2. 0.5 carbon produces how much more of CO2?
Okay, thanks. Why is it 1?
Because
times
2.
Yes, correct. So you could see the relation, right? 1, how to become 2, so it times 2, right? So it's 0.5 times 2, then this is 1. Okay, Jisha, that's you. If 1 mole of carbon produces 4 moles of carbon dioxide, 0.5 produces how much?
2.
Why is it 2? Alright. You all get it? Yeah, no? So if you prefer this method, then use this method, because some students find it easier rather than cross multiplication. Alright? Yeah.
Out of these two methods, which one will be accepted in O-level exam?
Both. Both methods.
But so you're supposed to write down the sentence?
For this method, you have to write down the sentence. If you're lazy, then you have to use the other method.
I still feel this method is easier.
For those who have learned secondary maths, you all find that this method is easier.
Yeah, prefer
yeah. But there's no right and wrong, there's no preference, up to you. Okay, so we have done these steps with ratio. This ratio allows us to find out the number of moles of carbon dioxide, correct? So this is step 2. Okay, so now we need to move on to step
3.
So let's go through step 3. So step 3 says change. Change what? Look at the questions carefully. What were they asking us to find? They asked us to calculate what?
Volume.
What do you have in step 2? In step 2, you always find
mole.
There's no other way they can find any other things except mole. In your step 2, you always find mole. So now I found out the mole, but the question was asking for volume. So what do you need to do? You have mole, but you need to change the volume. What do you need to do?
6 times 10 to the power.
You need to change. Alright? So it means that after you have done your ratio, you have to change. So these steps, Moraka, please remember the steps. So you have to change. Alright? Change. Okay, so which triangle that has volume? Okay, this triangle has volume, right? This triangle also has volume, right? This triangle has volume, right? This triangle has volume, right? That's all right. So which triangle can I use?
It's the third one.
This one. And which triangle shall I use? This one. It's the same, right? So my question is, why you all choose this? No? What did I say last week about this special triangle? This triangle, this triangle. Can only apply for?
Any scale.
Yes!
What?
This can only apply for gas. Can you see there's a letter G there? So this letter G tells you that you can only use this triangle to find your volume. Okay? So how do you find volume then? Volume equals to 24 times, what's your mole? 0.5. Press calculator, then you'll find out that your answer is 12. Yeah, okay. Can you answer?
Yeah, I tried and I found the weight. Not the volume.
Your copy finish?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's
a repeat, I can't use
the first one. Yeah. Very strict. Yeah,
very strict.
Mm-hmm.
The other one is for liquids and
aqueous
only, right?
Yeah, correct.
Because
of the concentration work.
Mm,
yeah,
it's very good. Correct.
Why else for the same
plan
except
from here? Mm-hmm. There will be a nice mm-hmm. concentration, I
don't
really say.
Yes.
Yes.
You can write the
conclusion
there.
Yeah, I can actually rephrase. Are you all done first? Then I'll change the question.
I haven't done yet.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay. So Morocco, remember? Can you remember? So.
What's
that? Tell me. The shake.
What shake
is that? Oh, that's called Morocco. Oh, I didn't know.
Okay.
That's Morocco lah.
Got some kind of hard
things
inside.
Then
shake.
Yeah,
oh.
So that's called Morocco, huh?
Oh. What do you mean the
chicken? Okay. What's the first step? Morocco. First step is what? Second step is what? First step is what?
More.
The first step.
Ratio and then change. More ratio change. Okay. More concentration. We need to find the concentration and the volume. Then we can find the mole.
I think
the first one is so easy. We need to find the concentration.
I want only Joshua, Jisha, or Xavier. You say 1.8, yes, but how do you get it? You have to teach the ones.
How do you get it?
I don't know. He say 1.8 what?
Yeah,
and then
H2O, H2O, there's a bottle.
Oh, I think I need the
period. Plus one, because you don't have it.
Just put
one more,
plus.
Oh, on top of them. So it's 1 over 1. 0.1 over 1.
One more. Just write one more on top all of them.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, the more is 0.1.
Yeah, then, no, just remember first. We'll keep a metal note inside here. Then 0.1 more, right? Containing the mass, then more times that.
0.1
times
1
equals 0.1.
Okay, that's the first step. Okay, wait. Did
you
say what?
0.1 times 1 equals
0.1. What does it mean? What is this?
This one is the...
How much? How many?
Which triangle are you using?
The bottom triangle.
The mole.
Only Xavier explains. Okay, Xavier, what is it here?
The mole of
concentration and volume. Why can you use this triangle? No, that's not the reason.
Because aqueous.
Correct, because this is aqueous. So, you take 0.1 times 1, you get 0.1. Okay, then what's the next step?
60 plus bracket 1 times 60.
What's your second step?
Ratio.
What is your second step?
Ratio, define the
ratio.
I think
we have done different
ways. Okay. Okay, Joshua, Jisha, and Xavier, you all listen up, no? I'm going to use different questions, but let's just go through this question one more time.
Yeah.
Okay, so Morocco. So the first step is change to mole. So the first step is change into mole. Okay, so how do we change into mole? So if you notice, this is the information given to us, and this is the sodium hydroxide, and this is aqueous. So therefore, this is the triangle you should be using. This is the triangle you should be using. Why? Because this triangle, last week we went through, say that you only apply for aqueous or liquid. So according to this formula, it's concentration times volume. So what's the concentration? It's 0.1. What is the volume? 1. 0.1 times 1, use calculator, is 0.1. That's your first step.
Oh, now, I know what it's called.
Okay.
Because
it's
mole, then ratio.
Yeah. Second step, ratio. So what do they want us to compare? They mentioned about sodium hydroxide, and they mentioned about water. Put your eyes onto these two. Alright? And what do they tell us? If there is no number before this chemical compound, it means it's 1. If there is no number before this chemical compound, it means it's 1. Okay? So according to here, 1 mole of NaOH, alright, produces 1 mole of water. But if you only have 0.1 mole of sodium hydroxide, you produce us, Joshua? If it's 1 mole of NaOH, correct. Why?
Times 1.
Correct, times 1. Why, where's the 1? This one, correct? So 0.1 times 1, so it's 0.1 mole of H2O. Then the third step, change. Alright, so mole ratio change. Alright, so change what?
Change 1 plus 18.
What formula are you using? You see, you are merely parroting what you have to understand. What triangle you are using?
The bottom triangle.
The bottom triangle? This bottom triangle?
No, the
mass.
This one, right?
Yes.
So what's the mass? The mass is equals to what times what?
0.1 times.
You see, Xavier, you are just parroting. So mass is basically mole times MR. So your mole is 0.1. Your MR comes from the periodic table. If you check your periodic table, the hydrogens, there is 2 numbers, and the oxygen has 2 numbers. The number that you're supposed to take is the one on the top. So there are 2 hydrogen, so it's 1 plus 1. There's 1 oxygen, 16. So therefore, it's 1.8 grams. So, Xavier, Jisha, and Joshua don't get it yet.
Go to the next question. We have to
stop. I suggest that you try on your own, then you're not sure, you ask the person on your the one beside you. Because if you just parrot, because on the exam there's no one parrot to you, then you don't know what's going on. Okay, how do you get 1.8? Very good. Good. This one is a bracket, correct? So you use this 1 plus 1 plus 16, which is 18, right? Okay, then 0.1 times 18 is?
Wait, I forgot to write the answer.
Is it 1.8 when you press?
Also, only
1.8
times
1.8 grams is the answer. Okay, one more time, different questions altogether. I only want to hear 3 person's voice. Xavier, Joshua, Tisha. The rest, if you want to talk, alright, you just whisper.
Alright, now.
Whisper.
Write down.
This thing can cover the whole page.
Like I said, I only want to hear Tree's versus voice. Yes, correct.
In Edson, would they write down the G, the gas, everything?
Yeah.
Wait, so we already done Tree.
Yeah, you done the others now? Then this is the change. The 1.8 grand.
Oh.
Hmm. Sure.
So the last question you were saying was the tree change.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, then the next, this one is...
This is the next question.
But not
I want you to try to solve. Only you, Xavier, and Disha.
Oh my god.
The reason why only these three are selected because...
And my mother pushed me. She's over there, sitting over there. So at her.
The reason was because this involves secondary maths. So it's a little bit more challenging. So the hint is always the physical state that they give you. Then once you know the physical state, automatically you're able to zoom in what triangle that you can use. Last week I mentioned that this triangle can only be applied, it can be applied to all physical states. Which means that solid also can, liquid also can, aqueous also can, gas is also can. Alright? And I also mentioned that this particular triangle, the one at the bottom, only applies when it is aqueous or liquid only. And lastly, this triangle can only be applied if it's a gas.
Can I discuss with
you? Can! Okay, don't worry. So this is gas.
I wish I can see.
Okay, what information they give you? Nitrogen. What do they give you?
They give you
volume. Alright, so which triangle should you be using?
The volume 24.
That's very good, Xavier. You say that, Xavier say that you should focus on this triangle that is mole times 24 equals to volume, correct? This is DMQ, right?
Yes, first is gas.
So how do you find the mole? Joshua.
Mole.
You have, what is the, okay, how do you use this triangle? Mole equals to what? Correct. But what is your volume?
1.2.
Very good. What is the answer? Use your calculator, please.
0.5
or 0.01?
0.07.
Okay. Okay, now Jisha's turn.
Yeah.
Okay, Jisha, stop. Look at me. Okay, step 2. So this is step 1, huh? Step 2. What is this number before the N2? Step 1 is this. Sorry, do step by step. Follow my methods. No, we overwhelm Ethan. We just follow this method first. Yeah, just like physics, if I teach you a lot of formulas, you also get overwhelmed, right? So you're trying to be understanding to those who are struggling with chemistry. Understand? Huh? There are many, there are many, many methods. In fact, actually like this, I already know the answer.
So smart.
But there's no point. There's no point me being smart. The whole point is you all have to learn. Okay, Jisha. What is this number before the N2? We take it slowly,
yeah?
1. Very good. So which one should you compare? There are 3, right?
which one should you compare? Because the word ratio means you need to compare something with something. So, what with what?
With any string.
N2. Why is it N2 with any string? Correct, you see the questions? So compare these two. So, one more of N2 produces what? How many more of NH3?
Two.
Yes. There's a two there. Very good. But what do you have? You have only about 0.05, right? Okay, therefore, it produces how much? Correct! 2 times 0.05. So, what's the answer?
0.1.
Correct! Very good! Okay, Xavier, third step. So the third step is change. Change what? Okay, Xavier, change what? Change what? Don't change me, change what? Change the what?
Mass.
Change to mass. Change from what to mass? Change the mole to mass, correct? So how do you change the mole to mass? Which triangle can you use? This one, right? I won't write anything, then you say yes. What? Okay. But what was this? What was the mass formula? Mass is equal to what, Xavier? Again, I can't hear you. You have to say with confidence. What?
More
than year. Year, what was that? More than what? Molar mass, correct. So 0.1. Where do you get the molar mass? Mister. Where do you get the molar mass? Oh, from where? Of what? So basically, you look at the periodic table, you have two numbers, correct? There's nitrogen and hydrogen, right? 1, 1. Then this is 7, 14, correct? So it's, how many nitrogen are there? 14
plus 1 plus 1 plus 1.
Very good, Jisha!
I thought it's 14 plus 1
plus
3. It's the same thing. It's the same thing, eh? So what's the
answer? 1.7,
right? 1.7, right? It's okay, Jisha. Follow these steps. I didn't realize there's something called Moraka. Okay, wait. Can you learn? Imagine, this is the pinnacle of chemical calculations in O level. If you can understand this, wow, very good. Really very good. This is my first time teaching 8-year-old mole concept. Or 9. You know that I ever use this question and tested all my P6 students? Which is like from top second primary school, and they don't know what they know what's going on. Yeah. No, they are really. Yeah. Yeah. Done. Have you all copied down? Okay.
G.
Okay, so we're going to up one level. This time round, there is not one anymore. In front of all the compounds and elements, has some numbers. Only three person as plus me can speak.
No.
Xavier, Tisha, and Joshua.
But when you're teaching us, you can also hear, so cannot. Must talk.
As you solve, you voice it out. Let me know your thoughts. One, two, three. Okay, just now Joshua solved step one, right? So now Tisha solved step one. Tisha, so what?
The mold.
The rainy one.
Wait,
that means
I do the
ratio. Later. Okay. You just get ready. What's the three steps? Actually, if best, we can do three steps, all three steps. Okay, Disha, what you need to do first? What's the first step? What mold? Find the mold of what? Why FE? Why find the mold of FE? But why not this? This one, this there, this also there. But why? Why must find more of this? Very good! So more, what's the formula, Tisha? Which formula should you use?
Use the one with the
one. Very good! So mass divided by MR. So Tisha, what is the mass?
Mass is
2.8. So what is the MR? How do you find the MR? Where do you get the MR? Why 56? But why 56? Why can't you pick 26? Why 56? Correct, that's the atomic mass. So 2.8 divided by 56 is?
0.05.
Okay, Xavier, your turn. Okay, second step. So what and what should you compare with?
解脱了, okay.
Okay. Xavier, which one, I'm asking you, which one should you compare? When it says mole, right, there's a ratio, right? Which one should you use to compare?
Nothing.
Why FE and FE 203? Why?
FE.
Because it was there. It was, you tell us.
Okay.
Correct? So one, so four mole of FE produces 2 mole of Fe2O3. So 0.05 mole of Fe produces
0.025.
Xavier. Yeah.
What is tricky?
Okay. Why is it 0.025? What do you do?
0.025.
Why you divide by 2?
Because
the previous
one is 4.
Correct. So the 4 divided by 2, you get 2. So therefore, 0.05, you also divide by 2, you get this.
Oh.
Third step, Joshua.
Haven't done copying.
Change.
Okay.
So, Joshua, what should we do next? What's the first step?
Change
what?
Change the
mode. To what?
To mass.
Why you have to change to mass? You say change to mass. Why change to mass?
Because you
should
find the mass.
Correct. They ask you to find the mass, so you change the mass. So, which formula should you use?
Moles is so hard.
Which one? This or this?
This
one. Okay, so what's the formula? Mass equals to?
Mass equals
to? What is the MR? What is the MR? MR of what? What MR of what? mR of what?
F
unit? Yes, correct. So there are two Fe, right? So what is the mR of Fe? Can you check from periodic table? In the periodic table, can you see this Fe?
Yeah.
26 and 56. Which numbers do you use? 56. So there are two 56, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Then plus what? In the oxygen, if you look at periodic table, there's an O, and then there's an 8, and a 16. Which number should you use?
16.
Correct. So how many 16 should you write? How many 16 should you write? Why 3?
Because there's 3.
Correct. So what's the answer here?
4.
4 grams.
4 grams.
Can we close the rules and everything?
Yeah, of course.
This
one?
Press
calculator.
This method? Mole ratio? This is a mole ratio method.
This question
Huh? Oh, stoichiometry and mole concept. It's mole concept and stoichiometry. Why like what? Like this, how do you become this, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, because how does 4 become the 2?
When you grow up, you need to be a photographer.
No, I'm not going to be. That is not just
land. You take
like that. Landscape. Yeah. Landscape means horizontal.
Yeah, we're taking the formula thing.
Formula.
Ah,
why is it so hard?
Because
it's hard. Because some people don't know.
I do know now. Now I just saw this one. CA bracket OH
bracket.
Nicholas and Nathan, yes.
Oh, I know why is this so hard.
Why is this so hard?
Because it's always hard.
Okay. Why?
Because it's hard. Not for
H1. How many for session A exam questions?
If you all don't even know why is it so hard?
Because it's very hard.
Calcium is 1C, only 1C. Calcium is C or C2.
Because it's a higher level.
Or C2.
That means you have to use more.
You all don't see the difference then from what you all can copy?
Oh, 1C.
This one is C2 or C8.
Correct. There's all these are only in words. So why? So why is it so difficult if you do it?
Because then you cannot find the like how much.
The words, you have to change yourself to the words.
Correct, you have to change yourself. That's what Jesus said. Change what?
How much?
Change it to
what?
Change it to your
So, and then you have to find the whole
yourself.
Oh, finally!
Calcium,
yes!
Calcium, right?
You realize that I didn't even
calcium.
Like this?
You didn't like write that and then...
Correct! I didn't write!
I already wrote it down.
Okay.
All in words already. He wants you to find yourself.
C-A.
Right?
Yes. Is this valid?
No.
Then
no,
how?
No, yeah, more.
Put two lah in your case.
Then put two in front of the
H. O, da. Wait, must we copy down that?
If you all want. Actually, these questions, I'm just giving a warning to Nicholas and Nathan only.
Oh, so that means we
will never come across this question.
I never ever. Isn't it inside?
So questions like this is another level.
It's super high.
Where you are supposed to come up with your own chemical equation. Even before you start solving. How is it, Chester?
Nope, got a bit lost.
What's the ratio?
Wait.
I don't know eh.
I don't know, great answer.
Yeah.
Is it 2.4 DNQ?
Yes, correct.
Huh?
Huh?
If your answer is 2.4 DNQ, it's correct.
Why?
First step, Moraka.
Moraka.
First step, change to mo.
Change to mo.
Can you tell me how to change the mo?
Mo.
Yeah. Huh? Okay, Disha, do you know?
No.
Joshua, do you know?
No.
Wait, what?
Disha, do you know?
No, what?
What's the first step? You say more, right?
More, right?
More of what?
Of where?
What's the more of
calcium?
Oh,
my
more of the calcium and the gas. H2O. Hydrogen 2.
You say again, find the more of what again? Find this one more. Do I have any information about this?
If you find
CA,
find
CA. Why CA? This is given.
And H2.
Okay, so what's the formula? Mole is equal to?
Mole is equal to
mass over Mr. Okay, so it's 4 divided by 4.
4 divided by 40.
0.1.
Divided by 40.
0.1. Yeah. 0.1. So 0.1 more. Okay. Xavier, what's the next step?
Ratio.
What? You should compare what with what? I found it that I couldn't find the answer and I'm not sure where my steps are, but then I doubt it's A correct. Yes, correct. This and this, right? So 1 mole of calcium produces 1 mole of H2, right? So therefore 0.1 mole of calcium produces Xavier, how much?
0.1.
Okay. Joshua, what's the next step?
Next step.
Find the ratio.
Find the ratio
is done already.
Oh, so now it's changed.
Change to what? Change what to what?
Change the mole.
Okay, change the mole.
Mass.
Change the mole to?
Mass.
To?
Mass.
To?
Mass.
To?
Look up there, the question, find the
do
volume.
So which triangle should you use?
Volume 24 mole.
Why that?
Because it has volume and mole.
That's not the reason. Why you can use that triangle?
Oh, because it's gas.
0.1.
Yeah, this is gas, right?
Yeah.
Yes. So what's the formula? Volume equals to what?
Volume equals to 24 times mole.
What is the mole?
But you didn't circle the hydrogen.
No, I should write, man. I circle this pen. Is it okay?
Okay.
Oh, okay, I circle it here.
One is red. Red means bad, green means over. Red means stop, green means but no yellow.
Photographer.
Nathan, Nicholas, Chester, and Ethan. Of course, all are supposed to speak up.
What do you mean?
Uncle
David
how? Picture. Uncle
David
how
what? How
Anyhow?
Anyhow.
Ammonium.
I said aluminium. It's not ammonium.
Ammonium.
ALCL3. Correct! ALCL3.
I search.
Oh my god. So resourceful. We learned this already. Aluminium chloride. What's the charge of aluminium? What's the charge of chloride? All these things you all learned already. This one is a minus. This is a 3 plus. So how do you combine them? Cross multiply, so that's why ALCL3.
Wow,
the one goes here, the 3 goes there. We learned this.
Must I copy down that whole question?
Oh yes! How about that?
Oh no! How about that?
Can
I copy
the whole
aluminium.
So you cannot Google, I will not allow phone.
Hooray!
Let's try
to then that is a... Super hooray!
So how you did? How for the challenge?
Are you doing it now?
Are you doing it now? That's good. So you found the balance calculation in H2,
right?
Yeah, I already wrote it on your
Very good! So that means only Ethan is far ahead now?
Yeah, I don't know
that.
Scary,
eh?
Aluminium
plus HCl.
How do you know
so
this
question
is correct? You can
just think of it. HCl. Correct, Ethan?
2.7.
Gives you what? Aluminium chloride. Is it this side? Okay, aluminium chloride. And then hydrogen. Correct? So now I need to fit in all the physical states. Correct? A metal, normally what state is that?
Solid.
Correct. So this one is aqueous. Why? Because they told us. Alright, ALCL3, what is the state? Aqueous. Why? Because it's given to us. Then what is this? This is gas. Why is it gas? Because they told us that it was a hydrogen gas. Right? But what is the next thing that I need to do? What I need to do here?
3HCl.
3HCl.
Wait, I thought it's H2, not H.
Hydrogen gas is
molecular mass.
So it's six HCl.
Oh, that's so messy. You just
try
to write
three. 3H2,
then 2ALCl3,
and then
2ALCl3.
Correct.
Wow, this is making my neck
pain. So, David, what's the more of HCl?
Thank you.
What's the more HCl?
Yeah.
Why more? How do you find more? I don't know.
Wait,
many.
Is it AL or AL?
Okay.
AL.
Oh,
okay. Well,
7.2.
I'm
not sure.
10.8. That is for Ethan. Chester is what?
10.8.
10.8, huh?
Versus.
Nicholas?
Mine.
Nathan? I don't know. You have to write down this
one. I'm still writing my things.
Oh man, I didn't
notice
that.
You see, you realize that. You see, sometimes, right? Doesn't mean that this information was given, means that I strictly have to always use this. Because I cannot find mole using hydrochloric acid. Why? Because something is missing here. This is an aqueous, right? There's only 0.5. 0.5 is here, right? But there's no volume. How to use? You cannot insist that I want to use this. If I don't have that information, just ignore this, move on to this. Use, yes, then focus on aluminium now. Actually, both are not per dm cube. This is concentration.
Oh, I thought it was slash or...
This is concentration.
You think they put slash for...
Yeah, true.
So, to find aluminium
first. Correct! Find aluminium first. So, mole is equal to what? Teacher. What's the formula? Mass divided by?
Mr.
Correct. So 2.7 divided by
2.7
gram divided by 37. Very good. So it's 0.1 mole. So that's the first step. Borata. One step is done.
Divided by
the volume equals to 24 mole,
the
one is only for gas.
Right.
So this will be not lah. Correct. So how?
So
what's
the next step, Chester? Ratio
0.6.
Sorry, I can't see the triangle.
So 2 moles
wait,
of aluminium.
What's the, is it
2.7
or
27?
27.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not sure, but
my new answer is
6.
Yeah. 2.6. The answer is this. Yeah, Ethan got it correct.
So cool. So yeah, I did it.
Then why didn't
you say? I suppose 0.5 after seconds after you, seriously.
I'm so
proud.
Very good.
0.6 DMQ, I got after seconds.
Okay. This is... Chester,
yeah.
If it's 0.1 more of aluminium,
I was a 2 seconds after you.
If 2 moles of aluminium reacts with 6 moles.
0.3.
Why is it 0.3?
Because times 3.
Times 3, correct.
0.1.
Okay, Nicholas, what's the next step? What's the next step after I've found the mole already? What's the last step? Moraka. Change. Correct? Change, right? Change from what to what?
I still question me.
Change from...
Change from mole to volume. Which triangle should you be using? Which triangle should you be using? 34. You should use this one. Should you use this one? Oh, okay. Why? Why use this triangle, Nicholas? This is for aqueous, correct. So volume is equals to mole divided by concentration. So mole is 0.1 divided by 0.3 divided by 0.5. So the answer is 0.6 dmq.
Wow.
Luckily, I'm not that high.
You're
not learning
this. Luckily, you are not that high.
Is this combined of you?
It's combined still.
Wait, you mean
take it as a challenge.
2 to 3 times harder than
this.
3 times.
Yeah.
3 times.
Okay, so this is how this game works.
Yeah.
Right? So, I will invite, you all can choose anyone in your member to come out.
Okay.
Alright, to come out.
Ethan first.
Alright.
Ethan first.
Huh? No, listen to my instructions. Yeah, have I finished talking? Okay, so... So you select one member of each team to come out. So stand next to me. If you know the answer, you just touch me. Alright, I don't want to have bruises, just touch me gently. I'm quite sensitive. Okay, so if I feel that you are the one who touch me first, then if you answer correctly, then your team, you can actually look at your team, whether you all want to take up these questions. Basically, these questions has multiple answers. I give an example. So, you all stand here. I just give a very simple example. What is, give me an example of a vowel. Example. So let's say Jishan came out and then he touched me. Then he say A. Alright? So A is correct. So you look at his team. Do we want to take up these questions? So if you want to answer these questions, so you all go back. So the rest of three of you all have to continue to answer what are the vowels.
Also,
I mean,
is it really
true?
Really?
So that means after she has A, then you'll say E, you'll say I, you'll say O. Something like that. Until you exhausted all of your answers, then only you get marks.
Wait,
that
means you
then
get
only this
6?
No. Once he has answered, for example, let's say Nathan already came out and answered.
Ethan.
Ethan has came out and already answered, then he's not supposed to help you all at all.
Wait, and also you also
can't
lost
help?
Can't help. Okay, let's just say that for example, AIOU, right? So this team, you all get ready. In any event, let's say Chester say G. That's the letter G. So G is not a vowel, correct? So the team profit can go over to you all. All you all need to do is to answer correctly and you get the rest of their marks. Everyone answer correctly, you get one mark. So for example, correct, wrong.
So you just wait for them to answer.
Yeah, then after they answer wrongly, they go to you, you all get correct, you all get all the four marks.
Wow.
So basically the team members who come out and answer has to be very confident that his team can answer the rest of the questions.
I must always pass one to them. Uncle David,
they get wrong and then pass over to them, they also get wrong.
Oh, then nobody get marks.
What if the first one in the team get wrong and then pass on to them?
Huh?
You want me the first one in the team who answer get wrong?
Yeah.
After
you're supposed to be how many marks here? All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's say that he say A, then he say G. Got it wrong, right? Then they got it correct. You'll get 4 marks also.
You just need one answer.
Correct. The opposing team just need to get one.
I have a question. No? But it's not fair. You see, we only got 3 people.
No, because
we have 3.
No. Doesn't mean that all questions will have 4 answers. Sometimes that particular questions may only have 3 answers.
Okay.
But if it has 4.
Mm-hmm. Then after I'll go back to you. What's wrong with that? There's nothing wrong. Okay?
Next time go back to me.
Okay. We can try. Okay, y'all select one person, come on. Please touch me gently.
What's the question
next? I will ask her. No, come on,
ask her.
No,
instructions,
maybe. Only one person,
Then we second the hard question, the hard part, then you go later.
No.
Okay,
the last one. The last question.
Okay. Make sure your table has no periodic table.
Ha!
Periodic table.
Why?
Okay, I have a quick.
I need
the
help.
Can you all just keep everything in the back?
Yeah.
How do we keep
the back? Okay, I'm
ready. Wait, I stopped
everything in the back.
Because
I say so. Just keep.
Collector can
or not? Just keep your calculators on top.
We cannot use calculators.
Okay.
We cannot use calculators.
No, can, just put it there. Okay, one.
Calculator.
Are you
ready?
Calculator. Are you
ready?
Okay.
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 Hey, cheater.
Okay, cheater.
Sit down. The rest, just sit down.
What are you supposed to do with this?
Okay. Just wait. Be patient. Can you like stand here?
Why?
Okay, then you stand here.
Why? Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't touch me first. Give me the example of noble gas. What?
Argon.
Correct. So wait, your team want to answer? Do you think your team want to answer?
Yes.
Okay, go on.
Then we get four.
Okay, sit down. Okay. Okay. Give me the examples of noble gas.
Xenon.
Correct.
Yeah, thanks. Okay, thanks.
Can we discuss?
No.
Yes.
Huh? 11, correct.
No. So you get
3.
4.
One more. You all can discuss right now, so that you can steal the points.
Okay,
pass on to the Okay, just one more. Just now you say
neon,
that. Neon, right?
Yes!
What did you say?
Neon. Good guy.
Okay, four points. Okay, next. So no more Chester, are they? Another person.
No more Chester.
Okay, then.
Okay, faster.
Oh no.
Give me the example of a
banana.
Atomic subparticles. Oh yeah.
Wait, atomic what?
Atomic subparticles.
What is atomic subparticles?
I know that,
Okay, what's so gentle? Rob! Okay, so go to the thing. Okay, so this question will go back to here. Okay, you all just go. Okay, what are you saying? Wrong. Okay, we'll say it's wrong. Subparticles means that refers to protons, neutrons, and electrons. Okay, next. Does your team want to answer? Okay, Joshua. Example of a covalent compound. Let's see,
Covalent.
Yeah.
What?
Covalent? I don't know. Give me an example of a covalent compound.
Can gesture?
No, of course not. You have to know whether your team can know answers. Correct! Very good! Water is an example of a covalent compound. NaCl. Wrong!
Metal.
Sodium chloride is a metal and a non-metal, that's why it's an ionic compound. Okay.
Methane.
Methane. Correct!
Yes!
What?
Okay, come on. Another person. Give me the example of an element in group 1.
No!
His words.
Group 1?
Okay. Oh my.
Majesty.
Hey.
Violet.
Give me the. Give me the formula for mole. Okay.
6 times 10 to the power of 4.
Ah, not correct. Example of formulas. Huh? Mass over MR. Mass over. You want to pick up this? Yes. Okay, so his first formula says that mole is mass divided by MR.
Oh, no,
okay.
not that.
Volume is 24 times mole.
Very good. Very good.
Need to have mole inside. Mole equals to concentration times volume.
Correct.
Huh?
There's a lot. Remember, there are 5 triangles here.
Can we give it to Nathan?
No, Nathan already said it.
Concentration.
Because you don't remember the big one. There's a small one here. Oh, yeah, any of formulas that we learn or more. So you all use mole equals to mass divided by MR. Mole equals to concentration times volume. Mole equals to what? The volume divided by 24. Come on. One more.
Then the divided by
one. Nathan, give it to Nathan, please. No, just give it to Nathan.
Okay, Nathan.
Concentration equals to concentration times volume.
What concentration? What unit and what unit? Because both are concentration.
Concentration. More per dn cube and the bottom one is g per dn cube.
Correct!
Yes!
No! 5 marks! So...
Okay, nice!
Nathan!
Okay, no, G-Shoe already.
Me?
No, because Nathan take, then you're Chester, then you're G-Shoe already.
Okay.
It's
just me!
Okay. Okay, give me the examples
of banana.
Of ionic compound.
That's too late.
Okay, wait up.
Ionic compound.
Ionic compound.
Hey!
Hey, no gesturing.
Hey!
Okay, time's up. Okay, what's the example?
Any?
CL. Any CL, correct. That's a people answer.
Nickel.
Okay, yes, Joshua.
No,
Ionic compound is metal with non-metal.
Oh! Sodium with oxygen.
Sodium with oxygen, what do you call that?
Ionic compound.
What's the name when you say sodium and oxygen? Because the oxygen, the name will change.
No, this
is...
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Sodium oxide.
Yes, correct.
You see, he
said... Magnesium oxide, correct.
One more.
Yeah.
Lithium fluoride.
Okay, but you have to touch me first before you draw.
Come here. Come here.
Okay, draw for me. Draw for me. And an example. Okay, draw a dot and cross diagram for me of a covalent compound. You hold on. No, no, y'all wait first, wait first. Everyone should have a paper, right? I give you one paper, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you all start thinking? Because if your team want to start, if he say that your team are confident of picking up this, you all should start drawing.
I am confident.
That's correct. So is your team taking up this question?
Just take.
Okay, just take. Okay, good. Okay, sit down.
Oh, wait. What else do you know? Hey, you can draw that one, I draw something else.
One more minute, I give you 1 minute to draw.
You draw a dairy uncle.
Got me. This is correct.
Yeah.
Okay, so I need 2 more drawings. No helping. So you all should get ready for one. You should get ready for one. Where's the paper that I passed to you all?
Oh no! Just
Draw. Not correct.
Wait, maybe they already draw.
Okay, then
what if I draw this one? Can I draw this one?
Yeah, I just need a
Never mind,
I just need a Never mind, doesn't matter. Covalent compound is basically a non-metal combined with a non-metal.
Hey, I'll just draw valence electron
carrier. Yeah.
Okay, am I good with...
Very good, correct.
Yes.
One more.
CF, try CF or CF or... CF or the formula for...
Already help you.
Not helping.
Not helping, please.
Okay, time's up. It's not correct.
Really?
Yes, correct.
We got 5 marks.
We are so dead.
No, he also
broke me. Sish, this is not complete also. Okay, next. This is also more 5 bucks.
Nicholas,
Not correct. Okay. I just need one from here.
Ethan,
choose
Ethan.
Oh, no.
Ethan,
choose
Ethan. Ethan, do.
Ethan,
Jish. Jish, then Ethan, do.
No, I'm almost done.
Then he's Ethan.
One valence electron.
Okay.
One valence electron.
Yeah, I
think
is this your answer they want to give?
I hope they don't get
it wrong. No, but wrong.
Yes, but I forgot to put this.
Which one?
Oh, it's all.
I forgot to put
this. Yes, correct.
Yes!
Back on track. One more 5 points there and die. We need on enough 5 points questions.
Okay.
Next one, you want
to get it. Yeah, the next one is a 5 points questions.
Okay. Just
think
of.
Go. Correct! Okay. Are you taking up this question? Taking up.
It has a high melting and boiling point.
Correct!
Oh,
you heard what he said just now, then you should repeat. Okay, yes, Chester?
Wait, it can conduct electricity in aqueous state.
Correct!
Hey, no helping out, no helping out.
The eye is molten. Yeah, you can go back.
No, I will jump.
Correct.
Yes, back on. Yes.
Last question. The winner takes all.
Later must go. Later, just go. You're a smart guy and touch him without anything. Even if you don't, just touch him.
Okay, so give me the properties of a covalent compound.
The properties of is a low melting and boiling point.
Correct.
Cannot conduct electricity under water.
Correct.
How soon? It cannot conduct electricity.